Yeah, good morning to all of you. Today we are discussing the SARPE ratio. This is the one of the important chapter in the investment analysis and portfolio management. Basically, when you are discussing the portfolio management means to minimize the risk factors in the investment terms. We are using the portfolio management, and this portfolio management will reduce our risk factors in the investment. So one of the important point is there the SARPE ratio that we'll discuss, and in the MBS based lesson we're discussing this one, and myself with the professor Rajiv Sinha, and we are discussing the SARPE ratio. So first we discuss the what is the SARPE ratio. The SARPE ratio formula used by the investors in order to calculate the excess returns over the risk-free returns. Excess returns over the risk-free returns. Suppose that you have invested in the, suppose that fixed deposit in the bank. So you will get the risk-free return there. Suppose that a risk-free return is, for example, the 7%. So if excess, if above the 7%, if you are getting, this is called the excess return over the risk-free returns if you are invested in the open market or the in the mutual fund, for example. So you can say that the SARPE ratio formula used by investor to in order to calculate the excess returns over the risk-free returns per unit of volatility of the portfolio, and according to the formula, risk-free returns rate of return is subtracted from the expected portfolio return. What return you are getting from the portfolio, and the resultant is divided by the standard deviation of the portfolio. So SARPE ratio is the RB minus RF divided by sigma p, where RP is the you can say that the expected portfolio returns from the market, and the RF is the risk free rate of returns, and the sigma p is the standard deviation of the portfolio. So return of a financial portfolio, a portfolio with the higher SARPE ratio is considered superior relative to its peers. If the SARPE ratio is higher, so it's called the superiors. The major was named after William F. SARPE, a Nobel laureate and the professor of finance in the mentors of the Stanford University. Now SARPE ratio measures the excess portfolio return over the risk-free rate related to its standard deviation. Normally, the 90-day treasury bill rate is taken as the proxy for the risk-free rate. So thing is that how is the SARPE ratio used in the select mutual fund? So that we will discuss. So first thing, that is analyze fund strategy. SARPE ratio, one of the most powerful tools used in the mutual fund selection. When we are taking the mutual fund second selection, for generally we are using the SARPE ratio also. As it is entirely quantitative in nature, it is quantitatively based on the what are the data you are getting. It provides objective feedbacks into the fund performance. So you can calculate your or justify your fund performance also with the help of the SARPE ratio. By looking at the SARPE ratio, you can access the degree of risk, what kind of risk factors are there into fund, which is earning extra returns over the risk-free rate. It is a standard tool to compare fund which is used use different strategy like growth or the value or the blend. Second point is there, optimum risk returns trade-off. Ideally, you might consider a fund desirable which have the higher SARPE ratio. So generally, we are taking those kind of in the portfolio management, those kind of fund we are taking which are having the higher SARPE ratio. However, the kind of perception may not always be fruitful if the fund took a lot of additional volatility. If the volatile natures are there in the fund, so it is not a kind of a good fund. It means that the fund is achieve 7% returns with the moderate volatility, with the always be better than the fund gives 8% return with a lot of up and downs. A higher SARPE ratio, that means the relationship between the fund risk and the returns is ideal. Third point, examine portfolio diversification. You may use the SARPE ratio to identify whether the new fund which you want to add to your existing portfolio would be beneficial or not. If you are making a portfolio and you wish to add some new fund in your portfolio, so with the help of SARPE ratio, we can identify in the
whether it is beneficial or not. Suppose that the current SARP ratio of your portfolio is 1.15, ideally the addition to an extra fund should increase the SARP ratio by lowering the overall risk and boosting the return. On the contract, if the SARP ratio dropped to 1.05, from 1.15 to 1.05, then it indicates that you need to revisit the decision or of diversification, that is adding the that fund to be existing portfolio. If you see the formula, that SARP ratio formula, the returns of portfolio minus risk-free rate upon standard deviation of the portfolio excess returns. So that will discuss the RP minus RF upon sigma P. So RP is the returns of portfolio, RF is the risk-free rate, and the sigma is the standard deviation of the portfolio of excess returns. So in SARP ratio, the performance evaluation process includes four desired per the relative component, like the major absolute returns, adjusted returns of risk, major relative returns, and the attributes performance. So thing is that how to calculate the SARP ratio. The SARP ratio is calculated by dividing the difference of returns of the portfolio and the risk-free rate by the standard deviation of the portfolio excess return, that already we have discussed in the formula. Through this we can evaluate the investment performance based on the risk-free returns. The higher SARP matrix is always better than the lower. The higher SARP matrix is always better than the lower. One, because a higher SARP indicate the portfolio is making a better investment decision. If the SARP ratio is the high, it always show the is the better portfolio investment decision, better investment decision in that particular portfolio. So SARP ratio always help to explain whether excess portfolio excess returns are due to the good investment decision or a result of too much risk. The higher the risk, higher returns, lower the risk, the lower returns. If one of the portfolio has a higher return than it is always its competitors, then it's a good investment, as the returns is high and the risk is the same. It is about the maximizing returns and reducing volatility. If the investment has the rate of return 15% and volatility is 0, then the SARP ratio will be infinite. As the volatility increases, the risk significance goes to and the returns will also increase. So if you see this graph, so we have plotted the graph over the x and y axis. In the x axis we have taken the standard deviation, one of the variables in the when we calculate the SARP ratio, and we have taken the returns. And RF in the y axis, just see, this is the risk free returns. And if you invest in the bond and the stocks, so this line shows our portfolio and the asset class mixed with the highest SARP ratio. So with the help of this graph, you can understand the basic concept related to the SARP ratio. So how to calculate the SARP ratio? Let us see the grading threshold of the SARP ratio. If the we are getting the SARP ratio less than 1, it is not good. If it between 1 and 1.99, so it's okay. If it is between 2 to 2.99, it's really good. And if SARP ratio more than 3, so it's the exception. So generally we are try to find out the SARP ratio its numerical value is the more than 3, and this give the best returns in our coming futures. So portfolio with the zero risk, like one of the treasury bill. In the treasury bill, you can say that with the money market instruments where you are getting the zero risk either investment of the risk free, there is no volatility and the no earning in excess of the risk free rate. That the SARP ratio is 0 in the portfolio. A matrix 1 to 3 has a higher rate of risk. If the matrix is above or equal to 3, it's considered great SARP measurement and the good investment. So definitely we have to get the SARP ratio more than 3. So it's a considered as a good investment. Where the matrix is between greater or equal to 1 and 2 or less than 2, it is considered just okay. And if the matrix is between greater than or equal to 2 or less than 3, then it's considered the really good. If the matrix is less than 1, then it is not considered the good. So this is a certain parameter that when we find out the SARP ratio, and we can decide the what kind of portfolio we are having and what kind of returns we will get by using the SARP ratio. So we have taken an example. Suppose there are two mutual funds. We compare with the different portfolio having the different risk level. Now let us see the Sharpe ratio to see which one is the better performing. Invested on mid-cap stock fund, we have taken the mid-cap stock fund and details are given. Portfolio returns are given the 35%. Risk-free returns are 15%, standard deviation is the 15%. Now, so the calculate the Sharpe ratio will be as follows. Sharpe ratio calculation. So definitely we will take the 35 minus 10 upon 15. So Sharpe ratio will be 1.3. So just putting the formula, you are getting the Sharpe ratio the 1.33. Investment in the blue chip fund, details are given as follow. Second is given the blue chip fund where the portfolio return is the 30%, risk-free rate is the 10%, the standard deviation is the 5. So formula is that when you find out the Sharpe ratio, so portfolio return minus risk-free rate divided by standard deviation. So calculation of the Sharpe ratio will be as follows. So Sharpe ratio will be 30 minus 10 by 5. So Sharpe ratio is 4 here. Therefore, Sharpe ratio in the above mutual fund are as below. In the blue chip fund, we are getting the Sharpe ratio is 4, which is more than 3. And the mid cap fund is the 1.33, is just between 1 and 2. So the blue chips mutual fund outperform mid cap mutual fund, but it does not mean the mid cap mutual fund perform well related to its risk level. The Sharpe ratio tells us the following thing: the blue chips fund performance better than the mid cap mutual fund related to the risk involved in the investment. Definitely, if the higher Sharpe ratio is there, the risk factors are involved in the investment. If the mid-cap mutual fund perform as well as the blue chips mutual fund related to risks, it will earn the higher returns. The blue chips mutual fund has the earned higher returns this year, but as high risk is high, hence it is the high volatility in the futures. But definitely the Sharpe ratio is 4, so definitely give a good return, but it is the high volatile in nature in coming future. So we are taking one more example. So here one investor holding a $5 lakh invested portfolio with an expected returns of 12%, volatility 10%. The efficient portfolio expected returns above 17%, volatility 12%. The risk-free interest is 4%. To calculate the Sharpe ratio, we can done on the basis expected rate of return 12%, 0.12, and the risk-free rate is the 4%, so 0.04. And volatility the 10%, so standard deviation, just divide it. So Sharpe ratio we are getting the 0.8, which is less than 1. So just show the calculation. So return on the portfolio 0 here, risk-free rate is the 0, standard deviation portfolio 0, and the Sharpe ratio is 0 you are getting. So Sharpe ratio Sharpe ratio formula, if you are putting in the formula, returns of portfolio minus risk-free rate by standard deviation portfolio. So we are getting the almost 0 here. So advantage of Sharpe ratio is follow. The ratio is the average returns returns earned in the excess of the risk-free rate per unit volatility of the total risk. Sharpe ratio helps to comparison of the investment. We can do the comparison of the investment if we have the two kind of different portfolio and two kind of different sector. Suppose that we invested in the in the ELSS mutual fund, or we are invested in the balanced mutual fund. So with in the two different portfolio, so we can do the comparison between the these two factors also. The comparison the investments. Sharpe ratio help to risk returns comparisons. What kind of risk factors are there involved in the when you're getting the returns? So we can also do the comparison between them. And there are some issue while using the Sharpe ratio to calculate the assumptions that the investment returns are normally distributed, and there the resulting the relevant interpretations of the Sharpe ratio to be misguided. Now significance of the Sharpe ratio. If you check the significance, if the two portfolio offer similar returns, then one with the higher standard deviation and with the lower Sharpe ratio, and in order to compensate the higher standard deviation and fund, if the higher standard deviation, so definitely since the standard deviation we are taking the denominator action, so definitely our returns will be less. And In order to compensate for the higher standard deviation, the fund need to generate the higher returns to maintain the higher surplus ratio. So in simple terms, it shows how the additional returns can be investor earned by taking additional risks. So the investor has to take the additional risks if he wish to get the more surplus ratio value will be more. So on that condition, because the standard, if the standard deviation will be high, so definitely returns will be less. It can be inferred that the surplus ratio risk-free assets is zero. So portfolio diversification with the assets having low to negative correlation tend to reduce the overall portfolio risks and the consequent increase the surplus ratio. For instance, let us take the portfolio with the comparison 50% equity and the 50% bond. Suppose that we have taken the in the portfolio and we have taken the levered form here. Take the 50% equity and the 50% bond in the portfolio returns and 20% and standard deviation is 10%. Let us take the risk free rate is 5% here. So if you calculate the surplus ratio, so what we are getting here? We are getting the 20 minus 5 divided by 10, so 1.5. So let add another asset class of the portfolio, namely the hedge fund. We have taken the hedge fund too. And the portfolio allocation 50% in the equity, 40% in the bond and the 10% in the hedge fund. After addition, the portfolio returns becomes 25% and the standard deviation remains 10. If the risk-free rate is 5%, so new surplus ratio will 2, which is much better than the previous portfolio, you can say that. This shows that the additional new assets can give a flip to the overall portfolio returns without adding any undue risks. This has the effect of the augmenting of the surplus ratio. And the surplus ratio, however, the relative measures of the risk-adjusted returns, it considers the isolation. It does not provide much information about the fund performance. Moreover, the measures consider the standard deviation, which assumes the systematical distributions of the returns. For a systematical returns distribution with the skewness greater than or greater or lesser than 0, the kurtosis greater or lesser than 3, the surplus ratio may not be good measures of performance. So consider standard deviation as the proxy for the risk has to be pitfalls. So, standard deviation take into account both the positive as well as the negative deviation of the returns from the means. However, it does not accurately measure the downward side risks. Measure the which only consider negative deviation from the means returns can remove the limitations or pressure to some extent. So if you like this video, please subscribe it. You will get the more video over this topic. Thank you very much.